So this is a quick little video to show you how to take two velocity components and see whether the flow is irrotational and whether it satisfies conservation of mass. It also shows that it is incompressible. So we have the x component of velocity, which is u, and the y component of velocity, which is v. And the first question is the flow irrotational? And you probably understand what that means physically, but what that means mathematically is that this omega z, which is the rotation, which equals 1/2 dv dx minus du dy, if this equals 0, then the flow is irrotational. And notice that what this is rotation in the z plane, and what we're looking at are what are called cross derivatives, dv dx minus du dy. So let's find dv dx, and if we look at dv dx, we find that the derivative is 2y. Let's look at du dy, and we find that this derivative is 2y, and we can see 2y minus 2y equals 0, so the answer to that question is yes, it is irrotational. Second, to satisfy the conservation of mass, now we look at derivatives of velocity with respect to the direction that the velocity is in, and instead of subtracting, we add. So to satisfy the conservation of mass, du dx plus dv dy has to equal 0. So now let's find du dx, and if we look at our equation for u, we find that du dx is minus 1 minus 2x. Now we look at dv dy, and that's 2x plus 1, and again, this is an x, and when we add the two of them together, we get, fortunately, 0, which means that conservation of mass is satisfied. Why does it also mean that it is incompressible? And the answer to that is this is also the volume dilatation rate. So if the volume dilatation rate equals 0, what it means is, again, since the mass doesn't change, then the volume doesn't change, and therefore the density doesn't change, and it is incompressible. Hope this helps.